live, laugh, and love, love, love.
It's the Gayle King Show. Love, love, love.
Hi, guys.
It is so hard to believe. It's only been 2 years since we first met the lovely Lady Gaga, but since then, listen to her track record. She's sold an incredible 14 million albums. She's won 5 Grammy Awards. And just this week, her newest single, Born This Way, became the 1,000th number one song on the Billboard Hot 100. Wow. But it's not just the music with the lovely lady. It's the full artistic package.
I'll never talk again. You've left me speechless, so speechless.
You would have been proud of me at the show the other
day.
Oh, I love how you, this is how you started. You don't? Now, I want to know how you do that move, that one.
This one?
This one.
It's just, I was born that way. Oh, I love you playing all the videos. I wish I had the new one to give you today. That would have been fun.
This is my favorite Gaga song.
You love me, Papa, paparazzi.
You have a good voice, Gayle.
The song, oh.
I know. I just adore you, Lady Gaga. Thank you so much.
Too.
Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
I had the best time at your show the other night. The best time.
Thanks so much.
I want to tell the favorite listeners, I wanted to do something special for you because, as you know, I'm a big square, so I got some fishnet pantyhose. I went to the show the other day with my favorite daughter, Kirby, and I was saying, you know, when Gaga comes, I want to do. And she goes, Mom, could you please just keep your dignity? So I want to show the viewing audience.
Who needs their dignity?
I want to show the viewing audience. This is how I greeted the lovely Lady Gaga when she arrived in the studio just moments ago.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you are showing them.
Welcome, Gaga. I didn't feel like wearing clothes today.
So Gaga comes into the studio. Oh, that's great. Gaga comes into the studio.
You like the outfit?
I do. You look great. We're kind of wearing.
When Gaga entered the studio, I was standing in there in my one-piece Spanx and my fishnet pantyhose.
She looks so. I have to let you know what I saw. When
okay,
I came
what
in
did you
because
see?
Because she has a smoking body that you're hiding underneath that dress.
No, but Gaga didn't even blink. She went, "Oh hi, you look great." Like it's normal for someone to be standing there greeting you in their underwear, Gaga.
Well, maybe you were born that way.
Maybe I was born that way. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Because clearly I saw a picture of you the other day in the New York Post, and you're walking around in your underwear and your fishnets and your jacket. And I'm wondering, is there ever anybody in your life that says to you, are you sure, Stephanie Gaga, do you really want to wear that outfit? Is there anybody that ever says that to you?
No,
ever.
It's just another day at the office.
No, for instance, like the meat costume, because I was a little worried about the meat dress, I have to say. When you came out with the meat, there was no one that says, are you sure that's the route that you want to go? Or do you just think people understand
well,
your creativity?
Well, I didn't really see the difference between wearing meat and wearing leather, and perhaps that was one of the things I was trying to say. I was trying to say a lot with that dress, and as usual with my ridiculous performance art statements, there's several statements, but... I don't wear fur, which is interesting. I don't wear fur. In fact, I really wanted a red mink coat, and I was telling everyone, all my friends this weekend, I have to find something that looks like mink, but isn't made of mink.
But is it mink?
Yeah, so I think that the statement is, to be honest, I don't think it's that different from wearing leather. I'm wearing leather right now, and no one has a problem with that. Maybe we should change the way we think about
things. But, I've read about you a lot, and what you always say is that you put a lot of thought into what you're going to wear. Will you take your glasses off now so I can see your eyes?
Yes,
pretty please.
I will.
Thank you. That you put.
I've been told.
No, you were asked. You were asked nicely, and I said please. That you always put a lot of thought into what you're going to wear.
Yes.
So, what was your motivation this morning? You said, "I'm going to the Gayle King show. The look I want to portray is." And what is this look?
Well, it's very New York. I just woke up in my New York apartment, and I just wanted to kind of be myself today. So I wore my a vintage Mugler cat suit. And these are my favorite shoes right now.
I don't know how you walk in the shoes.
They're creepers that were made into platforms. I'm very excited about that.
No, and then you tell me about the pointy shoulders and the points on your face.
Well,
that's distracting me just a little bit.
They've been here this whole time. But I waited until I put Born This Way out to let them come up for you to see them.
Oh, is that what happened? They've been there the whole time?
Yes.
This is what I like about you, Gaga, that you really don't take yourself so terribly seriously, but what you take your work very seriously.
Yes.
Do you not?
Well, I always like to say people take me too seriously and not seriously enough all at the same time.
Uh-huh. And what do you mean by that? What do you mean?
I think that today, in today's media and in pop culture today, there's an incredible amount of scrutiny around women and around pop singers in general or public figures. And I think, especially for someone like me who's in the entertainment business, showbiz.
Yeah, and it is showbiz.
It's showbiz. And I think that there's a tremendous amount of analysis that goes into everything, which is sort of twofold. Because on the one hand, when I sort of seed cultural statements into things that I do, people say, well, why are you doing that? And then if I don't, people say, you're boring.
You know, so. No, that's one thing people could never accuse you of, Lady Gaga, is being boring. When we come back, I went to your concert and we talked to some of your fans. I'm blown away by your fans. I want to play something for you that we did with your fans. This is a Gayle King show. Me and Gaga will be back right after the break.
Now back to the Gayle King Show.
You know what's so great about Gaga? The last time that she was here on the Gayle King Show, I said to you, is there anything that you would not wear? And I don't know if you remember your answer. Do you remember your answer at that time? You said...
What did I say?
Flip-flops.
Oh, yes.
You said flip-flops. I would never wear flip-flops. Have you added anything else to your list of things that you would not wear? Because I'm thinking, suppose you just want to run to 7-Eleven and you just want to get something quick. You want to run in and run out. You don't have time to do the lights, camera, action, full makeup. What do you wear?
I mean, I would probably just throw something on like this.
Really? This is like a
onesie.
Do you do makeup?
Yes, I love to do. That was a very big thing for me.
You never leave house without makeup?
No, I do sometimes if I just don't want to wear it. But I really, is that me?
That's you.
Yes, I'm wearing
it. So Gaga, you do walk around sometimes just in your natural, normal state, or do you? I am curious.
Yeah, of course I do. But I live a glamorous, stylish life that has nothing to do with money or anything. It's just the way I choose to live. So, I love getting dressed in the morning, and I think also for my fans and for the people that really believe in what I do, I think it's unfair to them if they see me like taking out the trash and a pair of flip-flops to sort of be like, what are you doing?
or you know, it is disappointing to people. You know, I'll be out somewhere and I certainly don't have all of the aura that you do.
I certainly wasn't disappointed when I arrived today and saw you.
I did that for you, there's no question. But people will say, you kind of look like Gayle King. I'll say, yeah, I am. And they go, are you in disguise? And you can just see the disappointment when you don't have on your TV face. So I could imagine if people see you and you're not all gaga'd up that people go, oh.
But I guess they never, my fans know that, you know, although I am a stylish person, I cannot be defined by my clothing. It's my music and my vision for us, that is what separates me. So I think in a way, they're sort of blind to my fashion in a way now. I think that they love me with no prejudice, and
with no prejudice back. The other day when we were at Madison Square Garden, we took a camera. Here's some of Gaga's little monsters.
Yay!
She personally has inspired me, like Born This Way, be who you are and own it.
I don't even know how to explain it on the spot. Like, it's just how you feel inside. For her, she inspires me.
This is my third attempt. This is the second cake. My favorite line that she's ever said is, once you kill a cow, you gotta make a burger. And it's kind of like, be persistent with your dreams. And that's a motto I live by. We all, you know, it's like a club. We're all freaks, but we all love each other and we love, you know, we love Gaga.
We love Gaga!
And you do encourage people to express themselves and be themselves. That's it. I don't want a bunch of people walking around trying to look like Gaga. I really don't.
Well, it's just about being who you are.
Who you are.
And Born This Way is all about that. And that's why in the lyrics I say my mama told me when I was young, we are all born superstars. Stars. Because my sense of identity came from my mom. And she used to put her makeup on every morning and do her hair. And she inspired me to always... be very ladylike in that sense, that I would never leave the house without being done up.
But Born This Way, I love this song because it's the first song that really, I've never heard the word transgender in a song. Can you play the Born This Way clip, please, Julie, the second clip that I pulled for Born This Way? People who feel that, who have been bullied, or people who feel ostracized, to let them know that they're okay. Why is that so important to you? Were you bullied, or did you feel like an outsider as a kid?
Yeah, I had friends in high school, but I was always kind of like the butt of the joke, you know?
What were you the butt? What did they say about you?
I was just, I was a theater girl, and I was really into music, and, why do you always do your hair for school? Why do you always do that? Why are you wearing your wig for your role in Adelaide and Guys and Dolls during class, And I was really passionate about music and the arts, and I was just really stood out in that way, especially going to an all-girls school in New York. Yes. You can imagine with the uniforms, there's very little way to sort of express your identity.
I can just see the nuns having many conversations about what to do about Stephanie.
They're still having those conversations.
What to do about Stephanie. So Born This Way, your latest single.
Yes. I want, when you talk about explicitly using the word transgendered in a song, I really wanted to make a record that was unapologetic and quite literal and really to the point. And, empowering music for females is something that has kind of washed away over the past 20 years. And I wanted to revive it. And I wanted to create something that was sort of a cultural religious experience, not religion in the way that talk about it in an institutional
way. It's an anthem.
Way,
it really is.
But an anthem, and something that didn't skirt around the issue or dance around the ideas with poetry or sex.
Oh, no.
Meant to be very, very right down the center.
You put it out there. And can I ask, is Lady Gaga in love? I saw someone very interesting backstage who seemed like a better half to Lady Gaga. What would you like us to know about him?
He does not exist.
Okay. All right. Fair enough.
But I do have some exciting news about the new single.
Okay, go ahead.
Well, I've been so excited about their reaction and seeing the fans be so excited during the show. Every time we play Born This Way now, it's only been twice, but it's been really amazing. I've made two music videos for the song. So there's one that's coming out on Monday at 11 a.m., but then I'm actually putting together another video that is a more stripped down version of the song that will be released on iTunes and also released as an audio file. My portion of the money raised selling the song is actually going to go towards an anti-bullying charity.
I love it. Thank you, Gaga. Do you ever worry about topping yourself? Do you think that, okay, I did that, now I gotta do you ever worry about that?
Well, I just don't care what people think of me, to be perfectly blunt. And I didn't get into this industry to become, worshipped by anyone. I'm not interested in being worshipped. Mm-hmm. I'm interested in worshipping my fans and making them feel worshipped. So, topping myself, no. The most important thing to me is that I always stick to my guns and I always do what I believe in. And I will never stop doing that, because the day that you put your own ego before the message that you're putting into the world is the day that your value as a woman and as an artist
You feel dead inside.
Yeah.
Thank you, Gaga. I'm still cheering you on. Thank you very much.
I'm cheering you on. I love Gail.
Thanks. We'll be back. Gail loves you too.